Good evening. I share with you the Labo Moto project and the experience between PAO-WHO and the Ministry of Health, DLR and National Lab to improve cholera surveillance in Haiti. For that, I do this plan for my presentation. The project start in September 2017, initially in the context that many suspected cases were not sample collected in Haiti. The project start in the department in the red box, and extended in June 2018 for department in green. Initially, the main activity was to assure the stock of cariblair in the institution, as it was reported usually lack of sample material in the healthcare center. This table in 2017 from 13,000 suspected cases, only 20+8% have sample collected for suspected cases on the department. In the three labs with culture capacity I use is for analysis is LNSP, Lab National for Haiti, Saint Marc and GSQ. For that, 45 the sample sending in laboratory, 45 sample it's the percentage of positive is 46. This is the maps to show the point of sample collected of Precepi, the national system for transportation support by CDC, World Bank, and PAO-WHO. This system collected the sample, and also the sample for acute diarrhea and other diseases from the 10 departments of Haiti. The system transports sample to national labs each 2 times by week, but some one area of difficult access and not covered by this system. This, the context I tell you now is the objective for why PAO do the project Labo Moto to support ministry. The general objective is to, under a cholera elimination perspective, to assure that all cholera suspected cases are collected by nurse institution. And the specific objective to add any time for the to attain the general objective. For that, you have to assure the stock of cariblair and the sample transportation and material. To assure also the training of healthcare provide on sample technique and biosafety. To transportation of the sample to the collection point of the lab national of the shoot point. To assure also the retro information for laboratory in the city there. And after all information have, to analysis and dissemination of the information of the Ministry of Health Care and the partner. This is the map to show the point of collection. Now the Labo Moto start. You see of the department the number of Labo Moto intervention. The summary of intervention of Labo Moto supports the national transportation the system for Haiti. The Labo Moto assure daily visit the institution in the red color, and to assure the transportation of sample and remove area difficult access of the point to collect the sample or to sending the sample directly in the lab. Here is the circuit for the activity for the project Labo Moto. They visit the CTDA and she verifies for the register of admission for the diarrhea. And if the if she see in the register have the suspected cases of cholera, she find to know if the cases have sample or not. If the cases have the sample, she assure the transport for cases in the laboratory of on or in the point of collection. And after, she assure also the retro information for lab to the institution and to assure the good decision for the response in the community. And also, if she finish this job, she saved the all data for the activity in the database for project, and I do the analysis for the result, and I send in this analysis for DLR and LNSP, the minister, also the partner for the response in the community. Now, this the table is for the monitoring for result the activity of Labo Moto in 2018 in Haiti. She visit 124 institution in Haiti, and 2015 visit for this institution, and 100 it's the number of training she do for the nurse do better sample in the institution. And she provide also the caribler in the institution. Now, it is the table for the number of cases in suspected cases in Haiti on 2018 is 45% of all cases is suspected. And now in the 2018, 30% of the cases is suspected of the cholera. This is the table for percentage for sample collected in the 2018 and the 2019. You can see the percentage of sample collected go better because you see in the week one, the number of suspected cases not have a sample is more, but you can see in the long time the percentage have now to 100% the suspected cases is collected. This is the result for the sample collected and sending in the laboratory, national laboratory and the CEMARC to analysis. And you can see this percentage of positivity by week and by here. And you can see now the N cases positive in Haiti it's of week 6 for this here. And it's only it's the cases tested by laboratory of CEMARC. And you can see also the percentage of positivity by seasonality. This is the CART monitor for the positive sample in the geographic area to better directly the response for the partner. This table, I do the comparison for the same period and for the last year and this year. You can see the number of suspected cases of the same period last year. It's too much, but this year you can see for the same period the number of cases suspected are down, and also the percent for positivity are also down this year. You can know by definition the not suspected cases, the sample are collected the last week, have 10% of positivity. And for this year, the percentage of positivity for the not case, the cases not suspected is 7%. Okay, this is the table for the exercise I do for the document, I do for the database for the project Labomoto and the campaign for OCV vaccine in the Mirbale in Center for IET, the Center Department of IET. And I need to tell you this information is not a certificate, but is the first information I do for the analysis. And I adapt the statutes of cases suspected or not suspected, and the result lab for the cases have vaccinated or not vaccinated. And you can see this table of the statute of OCV. The vaccinated cases and the result culture is negative, is 40. The percentage is 18.4%, and the positive is 17%, and the not vaccinated cases have 68%, and the vaccinated cases positive is 31%. Here you can see the effectivity for the vaccine. It's 45%. But you can see it's not. I'm not saying this data is improved, but I need to say the system of Labomoto can collect also maybe another time the information for the vaccination, or you can go back in the field and to assure that all cases in the database have the information. I can say that I can do the address and to find them to assure what is the vaccine these people take. It's the vaccine for cholera or not, and have the card for vaccine or not, and we can do a better analysis for this information. This is a table for performance indicator for the project Labomoto. And we can see here in for 2018 last year. And we can see the all cases, suspected cases have the sample is 18% collected. The sample is in the department to start the project Labomoto. And also the 17% for cases, the sample collected is the same date because the nurse Labomoto assured the training for the nurse in the city there. And also you can see the date of collected the sample and the date to receive the sample in the lab. It's 68% for the all sample taken arrive in early in the lab, because before the sample take maybe 2 weeks, 3 weeks before to come in the lab for testing. You can see also the date of receive the sample and the date for and the date to result. 47% for all sample have result in after 3 day testing by the lab, and 18.2% for all cases testing have the result, and the result are saved in the database for the project Labomoto. I do also the monitoring for the lab. You can see here the percent for positivity for the lab. You can see here the lab of Saint Mark have high percent for positivity to the lab, the national lab to IET. For that, I think the ministry can do continues the system for to testing and to do the control quality for the sample testing by the lab. The future plan for the project is to continue to use to support the MSPP toward the process of documentation, the verification of the transmission of the transmission interruption cholera in Haiti. Also to support the new surveillance and sampling strategy based in the national long-term plan. The quality assurance system from collection, transport, and testing, because I think the control quality and the biosafety for sample, it's very good to for this to continue to control the epidemic of cholera in Haiti. Also, for the future, vaccination activity access to improve vaccination effectiveness. The support in other disease outbreak, it diphtheria, vaccine preventable disease, and arbovirus. The lesson I learned for this project is the Labomoto project complements the national transportation system in the situation of outbreak and avoiding duplication. Cost-effective cooperation project is not too much, but is $3,015 million by here. The flexibility for project adapt to the challenge and another disease for outbreak in Haiti. And for that, I save this possibility to say thank you for the Ministry for Haiti to support this project and included this project in the protocol for surveillance for cholera in Haiti. Also, I want to say thank too much for the news for Labomoto, because I do a better project with them, and I want to say thank you. Maybe one day someone can see them. And also, I need to say too much thank you for the partner to support this project and to receive also the result for project and use this result for project for the intervention. I say thank you for the World Bank and also the regional power office accepted to support this project, and also the GTFC to invite power and included this project for the presentation. And thank you for support my English.
Thank you.